About to lose your mind with Notion? At first, it can seem like an amazing all-in-one tool with endless customization, but it can quickly become overwhelming to new users. In this video, we wanted to give you tips on how to get started with Notion and make the most of this tool. If you find this video helpful, be sure to like, subscribe, and turn on the notification bell. So our first tip that we have for Notion beginners is just to keep things simple. So don't be afraid that something looks very simple like this. For example, we have this weekly planner where we just have a monthly calendar here and some weekly plans that you can open up. So it can be as simple as a couple databases, and if it fits what you're looking for initially, you can kind of build on that. But don't be afraid to start simple and don't get too distracted by all the aesthetic templates out there. We also create ourselves some complicated templates, but for beginners, we really recommend to start with the basics. The next tip we have for you is just to get acquainted with the left-hand sidebar. So when you just hover on the left side, you'll get to this sidebar here, which is really useful for organizing your Notion workspace. So basically, if you're in your workspace, you can easily just add a page by clicking plus, and this can even act as your dashboard or folder. So if you just go here, now you can see that you have this. If you open up, you see that there's no pages inside. So you can easily, for example, add another page inside, like to-do list, and then you'll see it inside of here. So just getting acquainted with the left-hand sidebar is a really great tip for Notion beginners. So the next tip we wanted to cover is just keyboard shortcuts. So if you're just starting Notion, it's really useful if you know that you can type slash anywhere on the page and you can basically create anything from text, page, to-do list, headings, and so on. So let's say we have a heading 3, keyboard shortcuts, and then here we can type slash to-do list. And if you want to duplicate this, another useful keyboard shortcut is Commander Control D. So this can duplicate a bunch like this. And then you can simply drag it around the page as you need. You can even create columns like this by dragging it next to your block. So once you know the keyboard shortcuts and you start adding things to your page, you can easily just drag it around. The next tip we have for you is just to organize one page at a time. So if you're trying to build a habit tracker, just stick to your habit tracker here and try to finish that up before you start moving into adding more things and trying to create a whole entire life planner. We recommend you to just simply start easy. So if it's a habit tracker, all you would need is a calendar view. And you can do plus new calendar, and here you could have your habit tracker, and simply opening it up, you could learn that you can add check boxes here for each habit and so on. So by sticking with one sort of page at a time, it can really help you to build your own Notion workspace. The next tip we have for you is to use databases sparingly. So if you're initially starting Notion, we recommend maybe one or two databases and really try to keep the relations simple. So if we have, for example, a slash table, table view database here, and we start with a table view for our notes, then try to keep everything you need with your notes inside this one database. So often what we find with Notion beginners is now they start trying to make a topics database. So there would be another database for that. And this would be topics. And you try to relate these two together when actually you can simply add the topics as a tag. So whenever possible, try to add things as a tag or other kind of property before resorting to a database, especially if you're just getting started. So the next tip we have for you is to set small goals. So if you wanted to build a, for example, something like your ultimate digital journal overnight, that would just be very difficult and overwhelming for new Notion users. But instead, we would recommend you to start with something like we made with our Build With Me journal, which only has two databases. So here's what that one looks like. So as you can see, we have a gallery view of your journals and then a table view of your journal entries, and we had one simple relation between the two. So this is very easy for a beginner to set up, and we would recommend to start with a small goal first, even just keeping a list of your journal entries to begin, and then slowly adding your different journals could be another option. And this ties into our next tip, which is actually that the best way to learn Notion is by building. So whether that's just building what you need yourself and slowly growing with that, or to follow tutorials that actually show you step by step how to build and use, we really recommend learning Notion by building. So for example, this one is one of our YouTube videos that you can actually learn step by step how to build it from a completely blank page and turn it into this simple journal Notion template. And this could be very useful to learn Notion so that you can kind of build upon that and add your own customizations to it. So if you wanted more properties, you can add them yourself. And just learning from scratch is one of the best ways to learn Notion. The next thing to keep in mind is just to stay flexible. So your Notion is probably going to evolve as you go. And we've also experienced that same situation where we start in one format and one system, and we gradually move towards another as we grow and have different needs. So if you find this journal Notion template to become a little bit too limiting, you can start adding more to it. So if we check our ultimate journal, you'll notice that we've tabbed everything based on the different kinds of journal notebooks. We've decided to add tags based on it. We added some formulas that can show how many entries you have inside and so on. So these are all additions that you can make to your very basic journal. As you start wanting more features, you can search and figure out how you can add them yourself. You can notice that you might want some quick buttons and so on. So this can be kind of a process that evolves as you also learn the tool. So staying flexible with your system can be very helpful. Finally, having fun with Notion is really important. You can add things like widgets to your dashboard. You can play around with the icons like this. You can change up the cover photos and choose any kind of photo you want from Unsplash, or even add animated cover photos. So there's so many customizations that you can do, and that is part of the fun of Notion. For example, we've really had fun with our student planner templates. So as you can see, we added different kinds of dividers and even embedded Spotify in here and so on. So having fun is really important with Notion as well. So make sure not to forget about that. There's a lot of customizations you can also make with the fonts, and this can really spice up your page and keep you interested and have fun with your productivity and digital organization journey. Thank you so much for watching. If you're just getting started with Notion, we recommend our beginner-friendly templates as well as our YouTube playlist for learning Notion. Links are in the description. If you have any questions or comments, feel free to let us know, and we hope to see you all in the next video.